third ventricle. This is the cavity of third ventricle. It is a median kept between two thalamus. It is a cavity of diencephalon. It communicates with lateral ventricle through foramen of Monroe and communicates with fourth ventricle through aqueduct of Sylvius. This is interthalamic adhesion. Now, its roof is formed by undersurface of body of fornix. Anterior wall is formed by column of fornix. Here you can see column of fornix. This is anterior commissure. Floor, it is formed by here optic chiasma, then infundibulum of the pituitary gland, then mammillary body, then posterior perforated substance, and tegmentum part of the midbrain. Posterior wall, it is formed by posterior commissure, abnular commissure, and aqueduct of Sylvius. Lateral wall is formed by thalamus. You can see this section. These are the two thalamus, and this is the cleft of third ventricle. In this section also, you can see these two thalamus and cleft of third ventricle. Now we will see the recesses. Okay. One is the vulva called, that is between two diverging column of fornix here. Then there is a optic recess. Then there is a infundibular recess. Then posteriorly here there is pineal gland. So suprapineal recess and pineal recess.